no sorrow, no pain.
Yeah.
But I ain't got there yet.
Yeah.
I got a home where the wheelchairs can't come in.
Yeah.
I got a home where eyeglasses are not allowed.
Yeah.
I got a home where there be no hearing aids.
Yeah.
Glory to God for that.
Yeah.
Amen. I've got a home where there be no sickness, no sinus, no heart issue, no strokes, no cancer. Glory, I've got a home.
Yeah.
If it ever hits you that I really get to go to heaven.
Yeah.
I wouldn't get too excited.
Yeah.
Now try to calm yourself down. You're almost there. I said, I got a home, then I'm going to spend eternity in heaven with the one who loved me enough to give his only son and die for me. But Jim, he died for me and you and these precious men and women. He died. Jesus Christ died for, I wouldn't get excited and trying to hold your composure. I said, Jesus Christ died for you. Jesus Christ shed his blood for you. Now I won't get a little bit excited. Calm down. Calm down. Okay. Jesus Christ had mercy on us when we should have been in hell. Jesus Christ spared our lives when we should have been in hell. Jesus Christ, don't get excited. Calm down. Just kind of calm down. Keep it quiet. Hey, I said, Jesus Christ had mercy and showed grace to me. You need to get some of them. I'm against drugs, but I believe God will forgive you if you took one. I'm saying tonight, we come to that Sunday night church, and I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going home. So I thought I'd just tell you, I'm going to alert you. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to tell you, it's going to hurt a little bit there, but I'm going to tell you this. Y'all folk at church used to be shouted out before by the choir that been online, and y'all have got a seat of dryness or something sold in you, and I preach my ghost line up here, kind of scream and holler and try to motivate myself, and some of y'all sitting there on your seat, the view, and you're sitting out there. Now, I'm not saying we ain't never put up with this. We're not about to stop. You want tension, go down to Episcopalian. That's a good name for it, Episcopalian. Amen.
Come on, God. Come on.
That's pretty good one, y'all. I'm getting proud of it. I'm getting proud of it. Hey, if I was going to do this, I'd sit at home. Honest to God, I'd watch TV. I watch reruns of Gilligan's Island. I'm telling you, I'm giving a Proverbs report. Some of y'all now got some new folk coming excited, and then y'all older folk been there for a while, you sucking the joy right out of it.
Come on.
I preach on Joe Hemmers, and some of y'all being Joe Henry. I ain't got time for drama. And Joe, and I ain't got time for that stuff. I'm gonna go fishing. What's the name of the fish? Not a brim, but a what? Not a fish, it's not a brim, it's not a bass, but you fish for it in the pond. What? That's what you like to. Yeah, you said it, I didn't say it. But I'm saying it's time we get jacked up. Then let's start over the thing again. All right, back in. That's a reminder. How many glad you say it or not? That's what I'm talking about. It's jacked up now,
Frankie. Yeah.
Great God. All right, y'all stay right where you at. Hey, I got a special blessing. Brother Frankie has been in our church for several years. God's touching to get a word for the Lord tonight. One of the lay ministers. of the church here. Don't say much about that. You wouldn't know. He's very quiet. But the Lord told me to give him just a couple, about 2 minutes, just brag on the Lord. I'm going to flat brag on Jesus. Then got a special song or two after that. And then right before I preach, Dr. Walker will come up here, take about 5 minutes, just blow the snot out everywhere. And we're going to have a little church tonight, and we'll share a little message with you, okay? You can dial me if you want to. You'll meet God for it. But you better not dial me. I'll stop him starting 10 times. I'll walk back out, put you in the car, and get you back out. Walk in again. We're going to church tonight, Joe. If I got up on the wrong side of the bed, you better thank God you had a bed to lay in. Amen. You could be in a hospital bed. How many of you ever laid one of them? Oh, my God. It's much better to be in the house of God. I'd rather be crippled in the house of God than be eating cream gravy in a hospital bed. Man, the house of God can't be dead. Brother Frankie, here, Brother Frankie, I want you to go and brag on the Lord. Brother Frankie, just give us a little word for the Lord. Brag on Jesus.
There, just share something with me, brother. God bless you. Pray to God. Go ahead, just get the three or something. Get
the prank on the Lord. Tell them how good he is. Praise God.
He's good.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hey, we come back.
exhorters. He exhorted me, Brother Walker. I think in my heart, God, I had a rhythm three times. I don't know if I had a rhythm or just had a rhythm. But my God, I was in the mood. But pray God, it's God, you serve my life. That's the kind of preacher we need these days to keep God's people alive, alert, awake. The Lord's coming. I'm not kidding. He's saying, come in a cloud. It's going to be that cloud of us coming back with him.
Yeah.
And big, you don't say it's a white fluffy cloud. I say it's a bunch of saints and a white fluffy robe.
Yeah.
Cloud. Man, I ain't talking about putting your computer information in the cloud. No, I ain't talking about a cloud on your computer. I'm talking, I ain't talking about a thunder cloud. I'm talking about a trumpet cloud. He'll come down, he's going to blow the toot. He's going to toot. I'm going to scoot. We're going to shout out. And God's going to be cast out, bound in chains, flung off in hell for a thousand years. I'm going to shout out, bring God out. Amen. I don't get too excited. Frankie, thank you, preacher. I appreciate that. God bless you, man of God.